video will show you how to access LanSchool Air, explain several features of its interface, demonstrate how to add a new class, and show the various controls available while running a class. You will receive an email invitation to join LanSchool Air from an administrator. Click the activation link inside this email to create your LanSchool Air account. You may either create a password for the email address that received the invitation, or you can sign in to LanSchool Air using a Google account instead. The main screen in LanSchool Air is the My Classes section, which contains a card for each class that has been created. This includes My First Class, which is created for you the first time you access LanSchool Air. Additional classes can be created manually, imported from Clever or a CSV file by an administrator, or synced from a Google Classroom account. The menu in the top left of the screen allows you to get to the LanSchool Air Help Desk, send feedback to the LanSchool Air team, and check the current LanSchool Air version number. There may also be an option to sync your LanSchool Air account with Google Classroom if it has been enabled by your administrator. Click the link at the top of this menu to navigate to the My Classes page. The top right of the screen has a language icon that allows you to choose which language is used within LanSchool Air. There's also a bell icon that shows you notifications messages and a profile icon. Clicking on the profile icon shows you which account is currently signed in, allows you to switch between organizations if you are a member of more than one, and lets you sign out of LanSchool Air. You can switch from My Classes to Device Cart to view classes that have been created by an administrator. If the class you are teaching has not been imported into LanSchool Air, you can create a new class on the My Classes page by clicking the plus button. Enter a class name and description on the Details tab of the Classroom Settings box. Click the Create Class button to make the class and unlock further settings. Select one of the banner images for the class on the Details tab, or click the More button to see all available banner images. Select an image from the list and click the Done button to return to the Class Details tab. The Students tab of the Classroom Settings is used to add student devices into the class. Click the Add Student Devices button to open a list of available student devices. Select the student devices from the list that should be included in the new class. Search the list for specific students by student name or device type. If a student does not appear in the roster list, LanSchool Air may not be installed on their device. Check with your LanSchool Air administrator about getting the student added. Once finished making selections, click the Finish Adding button to add the selected devices into the class. Once class details have been entered and student devices have been added, you can click the Done button to finish setting up the new class. Click the gear icon in the corner of any class banner on the My Classes page to modify class details, edit the student device roster, or use the Configuration tab to delete the entire class. The My Class settings available on the bottom of the window allows you to change settings that are used for all classes. If the class was imported or created by an admin, some settings may not be available. The Web Limiting feature can be configured to allow specified websites, block specified websites, or restrict all websites. The Allow Only option will block everything except for the sites included in the list. The Block Only option will only block the websites included in the list. Either of these lists can include entire site domains such as google.com or specific subdomains such as docs.google.com. Using an asterisk wildcard within entries is also supported. An example of this is using an asterisk to indicate all subdomains under a specific site. Use the toggle switches to temporarily disable a specific item on the list. Web limiting settings are used for all classes, so you may not need to make any changes. The blank screen setting allows you to enter a custom message and select a background for the blank screen feature. This message is displayed on student screens whenever blank screen is turned on during a class. The setting applies to all classes, so you may not need to make any changes. Click a class banner on the My Classes page to open the classroom interface. The main part of this screen shows tiles for all student devices included in the current class roster. While a class is active, this section allows the teacher to see which students are online and what their students are currently viewing. Student screens will not appear unless the student is online and LanSchool Air is properly installed on their device. If a student clicks the Raise Hand button on their device during class, a red hand icon will show up on the student tile in the LanSchool Air classroom interface. Clicking this red hand icon will lower the hand for the student. A red chat icon will appear on the student tile whenever they send a message to the teacher. Click this icon to directly open this message in the chat window. The upper left of the classroom interface features the classroom toolbar. Exit class goes back to the My Classes page and ends the class if it is currently in progress. Start class will begin the current class for all student devices in the roster. The class can only be started within the active hour schedule that has been configured by an administrator. The Settings gear opens the settings page for the class, which includes class details, class roster, web limiting, and blank screen settings. Add Devices is a shortcut to the Add Student Devices section of the classroom settings. Add registered student devices from the list or use the Add New Student tab to create a temporary access link that can be used to quickly install LanSchool Air on new student Windows or Mac devices. Change Class View allows you to switch between grid, list, and group view layouts. While the class is active, this button also allows you to set Chromebook students to active tab view or to desktop view. Other devices will always show as desktop view. While in grid view, drag and drop student tiles to rearrange them. Sort students in list view by clicking any of the category headings. Select a student to view their screen and click the camera icon to save an image of their current screen. You may also see any browser tabs the student has open. Click on a tab to close it for the student, add it to the allowed sites list, or add it to the blocked sites list. Use group view to organize students into groups. Click the Add Group button to create a new group. Simply drag and drop student tiles into groups to rearrange them. The Change Tile Size button changes the size of the student device's tiles when in the grid or group view mode. The Push a Website button can open a website for all students in the class or for selected students. Use the Blank Student Screens button to blank or unblank screens for the entire class or for selected students. The blank screen message can be customized inside the class settings. The Limit Student Websites button will toggle the limiting feature on and off for the entire class or for selected students. The class settings determine which mode of website limiting is used. If a student attempts to navigate to a blocked site, a message about the site being blocked will be displayed for them that also includes a list of currently allowed sites. The Screenshot Students button will save an image of the current screens for the entire class or for selected students. The Share Screen button allows the teacher to share their screen with the class. Select the entire screen, a single application window, or a single Chrome browser tab, and click the Share button to begin sharing the screen. While sharing, turn on full screen mode to keep students from minimizing or closing the broadcast on their devices. Make sure to click the Stop Sharing button to turn off the screen sharing feature. Click the Show Chat button on the right side of the classroom interface to open the chat window. Use this window to send a message to the entire class or to an individual student by selecting one from the drop-down menu at the top of the chat window. Open the Options menu in the lower right of the chat window to disable and re-enable chat for the class. Disabling chat means that students will not be able to send any messages to the teacher. When finished using the chat window, close it using the Hide Chat button at the top of the window. When the class is over, click the Exit Class button to return to the My Classes page and end the class for all connected students. Doing this returns the student devices to normal operation, removing any web limiting or blank screen restrictions that may have been active during class. For more videos, user guides, and FAQs, or to chat with a member of the LanSchool team, visit the LanSchool Air Help Desk at helpdesk.landschoolair.com.